They will.
Shut up.
They will kill me. They will kill me, man.
It's become an image seared into our collective mind.
Well, David, I've watched the video of what happened and led to Mr. Floyd's death, and I will say the video is very disturbing and very troubling.
Eric Dryban leads the Civil Rights Division at the Department of Justice. He will oversee whether federal civil rights charges will be filed in the case, and the president wants the situation expedited.
The investigation is a high priority of ours. We are also working with state and local officials. But we will make an independent judgment, and we are about whether or not federal criminal charges or other action is warranted by the federal government.
If the DOJ moves forward, it would be under what is known as color of law prosecution. Law enforcement officers are generally given quite a bit of authority and leeway to safeguard justice. But it's a crime for anyone serving under color of law protection to violate the constitutional or federally protected rights of an individual.
We've prosecuted many, many police officers, other law enforcement officials around the country under that statute in criminal cases, and we will continue to do that.
Critics aren't so sure that there will be a good outcome. They point to past reluctance by this administration to pursue federal investigations against law enforcement agencies. Ultimately, time will tell if this case leads to federal civil rights charges. But the larger issue remains the state of race relations in America.
David, we have, I think, in our country, both a proud and a tragic history when it comes to civil rights issues. And I think what I've tried to do in working with our team of lawyers and investigators and others is convey that here in this country, all Americans are equal before the law, they're entitled to equal justice under the law, and that our goal is to account for and be mindful of the tragedies that have happened in our countries, a history of lynchings and slavery and other things, but at the same time to acknowledge that many, many people in our history have acted in a heroic way to bring about civil rights protections for all Americans.
For Dryban, one of those brave citizens is abolitionist Frederick Douglass, who escaped slavery and became known as the father of the civil rights movement in America. His portrait hangs near Dryban's office.
And I think as I go about my job on a day-to-day basis, I always look at the portrait that we have of Frederick Douglass and try to take inspiration from that.
In the meantime, the nation is watching and waiting. David Brody, CBN News, Washington.